This is a 1985 Mercedes-Benz 300D. You know, anybody can go buy a Volkswagen and put wheels and airbags on it and call it a build, but, you know, I took something I found on a 100-acre cow farm in Dunellen, Florida, and took something that wasn't relevant and made it relevant again. Turbo diesel, inline five. No, it doesn't make a lot of horsepower. No, it don't make a lot of torque. It's been lowered on cut coils done by my buddy Nick, and then after we cut it, we put the heavy duty Bilstein shocks, which helped out tremendously with the ride, because, you know, most people who cut their coils, their cars bounce real bad. This one, it doesn't bounce at all. It rides actually pretty smooth. I bought some old, like, Mercedes monoblocks for it, rode around like that for a while. Then we started doing the paint and body work on it, because it had like this part right here on the car was notorious, because there's like a tray right here. So all this was like rotted out, and it had like some rust holes, and it was just 30 something years old car, man. It had some minor blemishes. So took to the one guy, which I won't mention. The guy he had to do the body work did a tremendous job on it, because like he took, There's supposed to be like a trim piece that runs here. He took all that off, you know, welded in the holes. So he did a good job on the bodywork, but the paint job wasn't what I was expecting. It was supposed to be Brandywine, and it came out like shit. So my buddy Jabo got me in contact with his roommate, Jimmy Bergen, and I dropped it off with him. And he painted the second time, and it's actually a Volkswagen color. It's actually the R32 Mark V United Gray. And it had a little bit of purple pearl in it. So, and I was perfectly happy with it. You know, and I drove around for about a month, and then Jimmy hit me up. He's like, "Hey man, I wanna repaint the car." I was like, "Well, how much is it gonna cost me?" He's like, "Won't cost you nothing. Just, you know, time me having a car." I was like, "What can I have it there?" So I took it over there. He had it for a week, and he called me. He was like, "Hey man, how much is too much purple?" And I was like, "Well, purple is my favorite color, so it can never be too much." He said, "All right, you're gonna have over 100 grams of purple pearl to it." So I was like, "All right." And when me and my wife went and picked it up, it was still in the booth drying. And we walked up, you just see the flop in the paint. I fell in love right then. And then my wife actually found somebody was selling one of these down in St. Augustine for like, I think they wanted $500. I talked them down to $250. I bought a whole car. The only thing that was wrong with it, they had a blown transmission in it. So, and that one had a better interior than this one did. So I did a full interior swap out of that car into this car. I added the purple haze shifter. I added the beads because they feel good on the ass. I added the foam. I added the wheel. It was pretty much, I've gone through this entire car. I've replaced the CV axles. I mean, if you follow me on Instagram or Facebook or Twitter, you know, you've seen me complain about this car when something oh, I'm working on this today. I've, you know, this went out today. It's been a learning experience. It's, it's definitely taught me patience. Overall, man, it's just a, it's been a fun car to have. You know, you don't see many of them on the road anymore. You know, when everybody sees it, you know, they stop and ask questions about it. You know, what is it? What year is it? You know, they find out it's a diesel. Like, oh, that's cool. Oh, it's a turbo diesel. Oh, does it roll coal? No, it don't roll coal. The car people like it. You know, the new kids like it. The old people like it. I mean, when, I won a couple different trophies at this one show, and one of the old heads was like, man, what do you got in that car? I was like, what do you mean? He's like, you always win. I was like, so I got cocaine in the trunk. He's like, oh, I get them every time. And that was my inspiration for this car was 80 Drug Lord, Cocaine Cowboy from the 80s, Miami.
All right.
So how much of a baller do you feel in this car?
Fucking awesome, actually. It's fucking sick. All right, purple haze.
How's that air conditioning feel?
Fucking good, man. We gotta give it some fucking pedal before it moves, though.
Those things are landslide.
I love this wheel, man. You said it was custom made? Yep. No, it is. So if you don't mind me asking, what did the motor run you?
The new engine?
Yeah.
$500.
That's it?
That's it.
That's not bad.
No.
That's not bad at all.
It cost me $500 for the new engine. It cost me $1,000 for the install. It cost me about $300 in parts. Like new hoses.
This thing feels sick, dude. It just driven rides good for how low it is. Go straight?
Keep going straight, yeah. Try to hit the manhole covers with a tire.
Okay.
Gotcha. Because most of these manholes kind of have a, they kind of come up above the ground.
Yeah.
And
it was a strategy to driving this damn
thing. You'll definitely learn defensive techniques driving this car. I can tell you where all the bad dips are, what roads to avoid.
Yeah. But it's just like, I want to lie down and just fucking sleep, man. It's comfortable. Surprisingly comfortable. The brakes are really nice and tight, man.
Like, better be. They're all new.
All new? Yeah.
New rotors, new calipers, new shocks, new CV joints, CV axles. I've done the CV axles in this car 3 times.
Why is that?
Well,
because it's so low, it makes it wears.
Well, I had the exhaust coming straight out in the back. It had turned up, and I had a tractor flapper on it. Everybody thought it was cool. Well, the heat from the exhaust was actually warming up the boots, and every time you jack the car up, it would tear the boot. So I had the exhaust cut with a turndown pipe before the rear.
Yeah.
So that solved that problem, but I lost my turn up for what pipe. What else have I done? When I was in, you know, pretty much all the engines new. Or new to me anyway.
Yeah.
I got the new wheels at Christmas time. That was my wife's gift to me.
Oh. But I mean, she didn't find them. You found them, she just bought them.
Pretty much.
Right.
I was like, babe, I found this on the forum and they said these wheels will fit. She's like, oh, really? She waited till it was like a Black Friday deal or something.
Oh, really? So they were new?
Yeah, they were new.
I feel like, what's that movie called? Driving Daisy?
Driving Miss Daisy?
Driving Miss Daisy.
You'll find this old lady, we'll put her back. Old Granny-Panty Snatcher.
Exactly. I feel like back in the day, man, some thug on this car.
Well, that was the whole, that was my whole idea with the car. I was like,
yeah.
You know, Miami, Cocaine Cowboy, what would they drive?
Yeah.
A purple Benz with polished wheels. You see this car pull up to the corner. Window cracked down halfway.
You run.
See the deal. Window goes back up, drive off. Yeah. Only thing is, you couldn't get away from the cops in this thing.
Purple, yeah, it's slow.
It's slow and it's purple.
Where did you find this? How do you find this?
Huh?
You find it like on Amazon or something?
No, you make it.
Keep going straight?
Yeah, keep going straight. Boys in the Hood don't know if it's real or not. That's on them.
It's so old school, man. You can even see the needles in a cluster doing this thing because it's all by cable.
Because, oh yeah, the speedometer is, you know, has a cable that connects to it. Yeah. The oil pressure actually has an oil line that goes to it.
Yeah, nothing digital. Mm-hmm. That's cool, man. I like that. I like, ooh, shit. Yeah, I gotta be careful here. I like people that kind of stray off the beaten path, you know what I'm saying? Like, see something they like, and they just kind of go with it. Because even though you make it sound like it was pretty easy to do, it's not, man. Because, you know, like you said, the wheels are hard to find. Even probably hard to find somebody that works on these damn things, you know?
Yep. I've had a bunch of shops turn me down.
Really?
Because, one, being a diesel, two, being a Mercedes, three, being how old it is.
Yeah. Don't want to touch it.
Don't want to touch it. So you got to go to like Facebook groups, Mercedes forums, YouTube. I could pretty much be an ASC mechanic on this, certified for this thing just because of YouTube.
Yeah.
Everything I've done, pretty much I found on YouTube to do.
Yeah. But for a daily, man, this thing is freaking awesome.
I love it.
Let's get some highway speed. This is to the floor.
Standing on it.
Yeah. Thing slow as hell. But it sounds like a truck though, that's cool. Going this way?
Oh shit. What is Danny? He let you over.
Motherfucker.
If you wanted to give your kid a car,
yeah,
and you know they'd be safe because one, they're wrapped in steel.
Yeah.
You know, they're not gonna get hurt. Two, they're sure as hell ain't gonna speed in it.
You can't.
You know, they ain't drag racing nobody.
Yeah.
The only thing they might do is be able to hook a chain up to it and drag, you know, a Chevy 1500 around the block. That's about the only thing this thing's good for.
Yeah. Do you know any numbers on it as far as, you know, torque, how much it makes?
I think the horsepower was like 85 and the torque was like 123 or something like that. Yeah. I'm not sure.
But people, you know, people do things to them, right? To kind of boost them up a little bit?
Yeah, there's a, you can search W123 drift.
Yeah.
And it'll bring up some cars that were made in Finland. They beefed up for drift competitions.
Diesels too, right?
Yeah, and they're, oh my lord. Talking about rolling coal and hitting sideways.
I think it's absolutely dope that you went, you know, just different route. I kind of stuck with it no matter what. Trials and tribulations, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, I've had many arguments with my wife. You know, getting mad, wanting to sell it.
Yeah.
You know, just get disgruntled, get, you know, something happened and you go, I can't find a part. You know, oh, we ought to just sell it. You know, I might sell it, you know, buy something else, but stuck with it.
Yeah.
Didn't give up.
It pays off, man. It pays off. This thing is, you want it to be special, and this thing is special. You know what I'm saying? That's the main thing about it. I appreciate it.
No problem, buddy.
Thanks, sir.